Until very recently, I used to read about topics like mental health, like depression, like emotional abuse, like LGBTQ, in books by foreign authors. But I'm so glad that Indian authors are finally catching up. Hey guys, I'm Sankalpita and you're watching BookGeeks India, which is a channel where I make book-related videos. If you like books, if you love reading, make sure you subscribe to my channel, like and share my videos, turn that notification on. And guys, please do comment because you know it that I absolutely love it when you comment. In this video, I bring to you the book review of a book that is a very small yet significant step in talking about these issues, in talking about these social changes that are so needed in this country right now. I'm talking about the book Because It's Love by Kishore Nanda, which is a very good first attempt by a debut Indian author. Expect a book that is written in a simple language and that can be easily picked up by a beginner level reader. Expect a book that tells you not one story but four stories that run parallel to each other. So when you are actually reading this book, you will read four stories at the cost of one, at the price of one. Also expect a book that talks about love, that talks about hope, that talks about the goodness and the power of positivity. Finally, expect a book that talks about not just romantic love, but love of all types and all shapes and all sizes. It talks to us about a love that exists not just between a girl and a boy, but also between friends, also between family, also between a dog and a man, and a lot more. It's just a powerhouse of all types of love, and that is one thing which you should expect from this book. Like I told you guys, this book is written in a very simple language and easy to understand language. So it can be easily picked up by any beginner level reader. Basically, this book is a story of four individuals, Abhiram, Karan, Arif, and Rajesh. And these four people never meet each other, their lives never intersect. But their story kind of runs parallel to each other's. The first story is of Abhiram. Now, Abhiram is an elderly man whose family has left him because he contracted HIV/AIDS, and his family is very scared. Because they are scared for their lives and they are very ignorant about how it's caused and how does it spread. So they don't want to take risks, and that's the reason they ask their father to just go out and leave them alone. Abhiram is all hopeless and dejected because he doesn't know what to do with his life. He's so lonely, he's so scared, and he has no idea. But then he meets these three people, a prostitute Devika, a mentally retarded 11-year-old boy called Karthik, and a gay man called Aditya. So he meets these three people and he decides to adopt these three people as his children. And that's how his life changes. That's how these four people find love in each other. And I think it is this particular story which is the most honest, which is the most positive, and which is so beautiful, just so beautiful. The next story is of a guy called Karan. Now, Karan is a workaholic. He's consumed by money and he wants to live for money and only for money. And in the process of earning money, running after money, he somehow disconnects with his parents. He leaves them alone. He has not contacted them in years. And they obviously worry about him, but he's least bothered. All he cares for is money. But one fine day, his entire life changes when he realizes that he has a very incurable kind of cancer, intestinal cancer, and he doesn't have a lot to live. And it is while he is dejected and desolate that he comes across this boy called Aryan, who helps him find the meaning of life, find the meaning of happiness, and he kind of helps him in getting a girl. And this is the story of Karan and Aryan and how they find love, and how they find a love which is beyond any definition, which does not live by any definition. The next story is of a very evil guy. This guy is called Arif and he's an author who's written this book about a dying girl. He has written this book, but he has a very creative, evil, diabolical plan to sell his book. Basically, he's in search of a girl who is dying, and he is in search of this girl because he wants the girl to say that this is her story, the story that he has written, Arif has written. He thinks that if a dying girl confesses that she has written this story about her own life, the book will become a bestseller overnight, and that's what his plan is, that's what he wants to cash on. So this is a very diabolical plan that is hatched by Arif. But finally, his search for this dying girl takes him to Ananya, who's a beautiful young lady, and he inadvertently falls in love with her. So his life changes and he discovers the meaning of life. He discovers what true happiness really is. So this is the story of Arif and Ananya. Finally, guys, the last story is about Rajesh, who is this Casanova and who changes girlfriends very, very fast. So he likes to date a lot of girls and he changes girlfriends like he would change his clothes. And he's very braggy about it. He's very braggish about it. He loves to boast about it. But one day he meets this beautiful, sweet little dog who's a missing dog. And somehow that missing dog develops a liking for Rajesh and she doesn't want to leave him at all. So what kind of bond forms between these two, that dog, the missing dog and Rajesh? This is basically a story about canophilia, which means love for dogs. So it is a story that will appeal to dog lovers, which will appeal to people who are crazy about their pets. And yeah, because I also have two dogs and I absolutely love them, this is also a story which I hold very close to my heart. I think the characters are probably the best part of this book because there are so many of them and all of them have this simplistic charm which is very hard to resist. It's true that a lot of them have actions which are completely irrational, totally impractical, and somehow it is difficult to understand why somebody, some character is doing something. But in the end, they kind of grow on you and you learn to love them. So that's what I like about the characters. One thing that I did not like about the characters are how some characters are very unidimensional. So either they are very good or either they are very bad. And their transformation also from good to bad takes place like this. Either it's black or white. There's no gray in between. Basically, there are three things that I like about this book. The first and foremost, which is very important, guys, I cannot stress that enough. Now, what I mean is the reading comfort. So basically, if you look at this book, the margins are very comfortable. The font is very comfortable. There is adequate spacing in between the lines. So this makes the book a very comfortable read, which I can't say about a lot of Indian books. I am just dying why people don't pay attention, enough attention to this fact. Another thing that I like about this book is the way it includes diversity. It talks about relevant issues, socially relevant issues, which are much needed in current Indian society. And we really need to change the way people think about LGBTQ, about depression, about mental health, about emotional abuse. So these are the things that are addressed in this book and kudos, it's a very good effort. Finally, guys, the last thing that I loved about this book is that it talks about not just romantic love. Now, when you look at the cover, you would think that it's a love story. Of course, it is a love story, but it's not just about romantic love between a girl and a boy. So this book encompasses love in all its forms and shapes and size and color, and that is what I loved about it. There are two things that I did not like in this book. The first is that almost the entire story is revealed in the blurb. So there is no motivation for the reader to pick it up because, you know, in the blurb itself, everything is known. There are no plot twists. There are no surprises along the way. So while you are reading it, you already know what the end is going to be like. And like I said, there are no plot twists. That creativity in terms of keeping the reader's interest up all the time is missing. Another thing that I did not like in this book is that it is very repetitive. So a lot of characters go on this rhetoric monologue that talks about the same thing all over again. So if somebody is talking about how money is not everything, they will keep on talking about it throughout the book and that just pisses me off. The editing of this book is one thing that could surely have been better. When it comes to Because It's Love, there are a lot of issues with editing, with spelling mistakes, with grammatical errors. And I also believe the writing also could have been a little fine-tuned and polished because it's a little amateurish. And that's the reason it might not appeal to people who are voracious readers, people who are intermediate level readers. Talking about the climax is okay, just okay. Like I told you, everything is revealed in the blurb itself and there's simply no motivation for the reader to read what lies ahead. So basically, the climax was pretty mediocre. I don't think the book is entertaining. Yes, it has a lot of good things, but when it comes to entertainment, it does not give you a lot because there's no surprise twist. The writing is lackluster. It is also monotonous and tedious and repetitive, and all the things that can go wrong, with entertainment goes wrong in this book. My final rating for the book is 3 out of 5 stars. Pick up this book if you are a beginner level reader, if you are interested in reading about stories of four different people or reading four different stories in one book. Pick up this book if you're looking for stories that are mildly inspiring. Pick up this book if you enjoy books that have character transformations from good to bad, from bad to good, and things like that. Pick up this book if you're looking for a book that talks about not just romantic love, but all kinds of love. And finally, pick up this book if you like books that talk about burning social issues. Skip this book if you don't like books that are slow in pace and a little less entertaining. Skip this book if you're looking for a romantic read. Skip this book if you're looking only for a 4 or 5 star read. Skip this book if you're looking for a literary read. Skip this book if you're a voracious reader or you read a lot of books in a given month. And finally, skip this book if you don't like books that lack thrill and pace and entertainment. So that's it from me in this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to hit that like. Also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And until the next video, which will be pretty soon. Bye.